I'd like to introduce myself, and this is me. This was actually my moment of truth as a football player. The highest level I could compete at, it was a local team from a city in the Netherlands called Apeldoorn, and we were the 11 best players of Apeldoorn. I was 12 years old. This was my moment, and afterwards it went down. But I was playing for the KNVB, for the Dutch Federation, already back then. And nowadays I still do something for the KNVB, just work for them, and I'm their head of marketing. Digital and football is something we can talk a lot about. There's a lot of stuff going on, and we could all, we could do, I could tell you a lot about great activations, great fan engagement things you could do. This is an example from the Dallas Mavericks, actually a basketball club, what they are doing with Minecraft, brilliant activation. This is something from Argentina. They are implanting a microchip into fans, to help with stadium security, sort of a season ticket into their arms, which is kind of a strange thing to do. And we could also talk about esports. This is West Ham United, and West Ham United just transferred an esports guy into their team. They paid for him, and he's playing esports for the team. So there's a lot of digital and football going on. And at the KNVB, we also do a lot of nice, sexy stuff with digital. But we can do all this great, innovative stuff. But it only makes sense if it helps in your business perspective. And from a federation perspective, what we really aim to do is we like to get our football players or football lovers in the Netherlands to enjoy the game of football for as long as possible, so a lifelong of football. And also, at the same time, we have the responsibility to nurture the game of football in the Netherlands, and that way to grow the football landscape for both our professional club and our local clubs. So we have a sort of a different responsibility than some other companies. And I'm going to talk to you today a little bit about analytics and how we use it in order to increase all this this football landscape in the Netherlands. And to do that, it might be useful to start with a short overview of the football landscape in the Netherlands. What does it look like? And in the Netherlands, the football landscape is actually something like this. We have about 70 million people living in the Netherlands, and about 1.25 million of them play football at our local clubs. And we have about 10 million football fans in the Netherlands. And all these 1.25 million people who are playing football, the game needs to be organized at the local club. So there are about 400,000 volunteers who are organizing all these games, referees, coaches, in the canteens. Everybody's working together to make all these people enjoy football. And we have about 3,100 clubs in the Netherlands. So this landscape is actually a pretty solid base for us compared to some other countries. So for example, this is our case. In the Netherlands, 66% of all football players play at local clubs who are part of the KNVB. If you would compare that to other countries, you would see that in most countries, this number is quite different. It's a little bit lower. So we have a really high penetration of local football clubs and players who are playing there, and it's a difference we can use. Also, if you look at the total number of football players in the Netherlands, you saw the 1.25 million, which is about 7% of the Dutch population playing football. And if you would compare that to the same countries, you would see that it's actually a little bit less than Germany, but a lot more than England, France, Spain, and other examples. So the penetration of football in the Netherlands is quite good. And what we have done about 15 years ago, we have organized, because all these local clubs are, they are organized by volunteers. And we have organized 15 years ago that the administration of all these football players being member of a club is centralized and shared with the KNVB, with the Dutch Federation. So we have information of all the 1.25 million people, folks playing football in the Netherlands, and also the former players in the Netherlands, which makes quite a good base and database of football profiles in our country. So what do we know about all these football lovers? Well, we know one thing. We know this graph. This is a pretty important one for us. This is the customer life cycle, the customer lifetime value of football players in the Netherlands, or football fans, or football lovers in the Netherlands. And what you see here, the blue line, this is a, I know it's a difficult graph probably to read for you from a distance. I just got this at the end of last week. The blue line is the line which shows the customer lifetime value of football players who are a member of a local football club in the Netherlands. The green line is football players who used to be a member of local clubs. And the red line is football lovers who have never played football actively themselves. So what we see, the customer lifetime value is, you know, much higher if you have been playing or are still playing football in nowadays, which is, you know, pretty obvious, but it's nice to know the numbers of it. It's pretty obvious because if you play football, there's a bigger chance that you're a fan of football, and also a bigger chance that you spend your money on merchandise because you want to play in a kit and you want to, you know, do all this stuff in there. So this is an important one for us. And our research in this side keep showing up the same numbers actually. So of all these volunteers in the local clubs, about 85-90% of them, they have been playing football in their past themselves actively, or they are still playing actively. Of all the fans that are in our stadiums, of all the professional clubs, about 90% are still playing or have been playing football. It keeps going on and keeps going on. The merchandise sales of fans at local at professional football clubs, so for example Ajax or PSV, who are still playing football themselves, they spend about twice as much on merchandise compared to non-players. And they're just the fans of the same club, just difference in spending. So we have a responsibility to grow the total football landscape, and we know that active playing and being an active participant at this moment, still playing at a local club, is a good sign of how much you're going to spend on the game of football. What we are trying to do with that knowledge is we sort of mapped out the football landscape in the Netherlands. So you have footballers, men or women, and you have fans and you have volunteers. Those are the three type of roles you can have within football. And you have all these life cycles, these ages in which you're currently in. And what we try to do is we try to convert everybody from one cell to the other cell, and also try to convert them from cells up and down. So if you're a footballer, we try to convert them into a volunteer. So actually the previous presenter was talking a little bit about upselling. This is something that we keep on and trying to do within our business. Only difference is that our business is really offline because it's all playing on local pitches instead of a Prezi on an online platform. So this is sort of the holy grail we're using in the Netherlands. And the thing is, the question is, what do we know about these football lovers? And we know quite a lot about them. We know they're obviously from the centralized administration. It's called Sportlink, it's in the top. We know the data of their participation history or participation lives. But we also know, we have an online platform, it's called football.nl, in which every match statistic is shared, and almost everybody who's playing football in the Netherlands uses that site. So we know a lot about their online behavior. And we also know a lot about their ticketing sales because we bind it together, the information in the profiles. We know a lot about their merchandising spending. We try to use our campaigns and get the information back into a database. And we also have their fan database from the Dutch national team. So we know quite a lot about it. And we started about 4 or 5 years ago to get this data and combine it together. And we actually use it to commercially sell it. That's what we use it for. We got all this data together and we just sold it to advertisers, and we made some money with it, and we used the money to keep the fees for the membership low, and we keep the prices for the Dutch national team as low as possible. So we just only commercialized it. And that was really, really a waste of a lot of good information because we could use it also for our own purposes. So our question became, how can we understand the football lover even better? Because the information in the first database in which we did all the analytics for commercial purposes, just selling the data, all this data, the only cells that were used, that were filled in there, were the ones that were commercially viable, that were logical to use and to exploit. But there's a lot of information that you could use for your own purposes, which is not interesting for a lot of partners, but it's really interesting for yourself. So we binded together all this information that we didn't use before, and we got it. We combined it into one big, actually, football intelligence platform, and that's what we started. But we couldn't do it on our own because we are, you know, a football federation. We are not a federation of analysts, not of scientists, data scientists. So we needed a lot of help, and we got the help from a company which is called SAS. Maybe you've heard of it. I think it's the best analytic analyzing program or software in the Netherlands and maybe even worldwide. And we asked them to help us with all this analysis. And what we then did was. This was about a year ago. We combined all this data, and then we needed to analyze it even more. So we got our team internally and formed it, and you know they do some brilliant stuff, but they are with the two of them. So there's only so much you can do. So what we're doing with SAS right now is we are trying to get more data scientists, data analysts to help us figure out all this data, because there is a lot of it going on and going in there. What we did 2 or 3 months ago, we organized a football hackathon, it's called, at the local or at our national cup final. We had 20 of the brightest data scientists in the Netherlands, and we got them together and we asked them to make sort of an alternative year report for ourselves using all this data. 24 hours, 20 students, and we got great insights. We got insights about performance on artificial pitches versus natural grass, which is a big thing for football players. There's no difference. It's the same. It's all the same. The results are all the same. We got information on red cards. Teams who are playing in a red kit, they get more red cards than teams who are playing in a black kit, which is something we can use, but it's nice to know. But we also got some really good information in which regions women's football has a lot of potential to grow, in which regions we could do some other products. So in only 24 hours, we got all these bright students to help us there. And we're using them right now. We are acquiring and recruiting 4 or 5 of them to become a structural part of our team. And also this information, we use it ourselves. So we use all this basic information from local clubs, for membership programs, for learning which regions are best to acquire more football players. We use it in ticket sales, which days, which regions, which nationalities, which everything is best to sell to. We use it to really increase our efficiency in mailings for our own purposes. So our CTOs and CTRs are, I think, pretty okay and pretty solid compared to a lot of it in the Netherlands. And we also use it for emailings for our partners. And this has been happening in the past year or so. And now the actual challenge is how to use all this data and how to get even more data and increase the football experience. Because that's a challenge. How can you increase and use digital and use analytics to increase the experience of the football players in the Netherlands again? So what does the future look like for us? Well, it starts with our mobile app. It's used by approximately 1 million of the 1.2 million players in the Netherlands. And it's got all the data in there from the game, from the competition, from everything you can have there. We're renewing it right now, and we're having a new release in about a few months, which is going to include digital match forms, digital player passes, team communication, everything you need to organize your match. it's going to be on this app. And that's a big increase because it's going to give us a lot of data on every goal scorer, every yellow and red card, every thing that's going on the pitch. It's going to be made available to us. And we also, it's going to give us a lot of data, but we can also make the app something that enriches the football experience of all these football players. So, for example, we're currently working right now on a video system, which is installed at local pitches, and the video system is just recording every match on this pitch, and also automatically following the ball, making making great video content over there, and within 10 seconds, every great action on a pitch, goal, move, whatever, is shared online through all the socials you can use. So that means we have about 35,000 matches each weekend. If we could have one video system at all local clubs, at each local club, it's going to give us about 15,000 matches each weekend. And it's going to be a huge, huge content platform, and video content, and real-time video content, actually, which is going to increase. I mean, if you're playing a game and you're scoring a goal and you can share it with your friends online because it's been taped, that's a great feeling. And everybody who's playing football in the Netherlands and in the world knows, the best action, the best move of his career. They know it. They're going to tell it. They're going to tell it for years to come at parties in the cafe. And now they're going to have it on, on tape, and they can share it. And this is going to be something we really, really believe in. And we can also connect it with narrowcasting system in the local clubs. We can connect it with broadcasters to have the top 25, performances or top 25 actions of this weekend on amateur pitches on television or online. So there's a lot of opportunity there, and we're going to have it into a sort of a video live ticker in the app. So at every match, whenever you're looking for your last match result or what the opponents are doing, then you have the video live ticker with all the video content in there. So we are quite hopeful it will give us a lot more to use in both the data and also in the user experience for our football players. And that's actually the last thing I wanted to say.